Hello everyone. Welcome to Management Kaksha, a one-stop solution for all your management-related queries. In today's video, we will be talking about the very famous Hawthorne experiments conducted by Elton Mayo. The contents of this video are Introduction to Hawthorne experiments, the illumination experiment, relay assembly test room experiment, interviewing program, bank wiring test room experiment, and the contributions of Hawthorne experiments. Introduction to Hawthorne experiments. At the beginning of the 20th century, companies were using scientific approaches to improve worker productivity. So this was done in scientific management by Taylor, administrative management by Henry Fayol. But all this began to change in 1920s with the start of Hawthorne Studies, a 9-year research program at Western Electric Company. The program, which was led by Elton Mayo and Fritz Rottersberger, played a major role in concluding that an organization's undocumented social system was a powerful motivator of employee behavior. The Hawthorne studies led to the development of the human relations movement in business management. The Hawthorne studies were a part of a refocus on managerial strategy, incorporating the socio-psychological aspects of human behavior in the organizations. The experiments which were conducted in the Hawthorne experiments were about measuring the impact of different working conditions such as levels of lighting, payment systems, and hours of work on the output of the employees. The researchers concluded that the variation in output were not caused by changing physical conditions. Elton Mayo's importance to management lies in the fact that he established evidence on the value of a management approach and style, which was considered to be an alternative to Taylor's scientific management. Now, the results which were drawn out of the Hawthorne experiments were a major blow to the position of scientific management, which held that the employees were motivated by individual economic interest. The Hawthorne studies, however, concluded that social need was an additional essential source of motivation, and economic incentives were just viewed as one factor but not the sole factors to which employees responded. Now, this is the picture of the famous duo of the Hawthorne experiments, Elton Mayo and Fritz Rottersberger. And this is the Western Electric Company as of in 1920s, which was the maker of Bell telephones, where the Hawthorne experiments were conducted. The first experiment that was taken place at the Hawthorne studies were the illumination experiments. Illumination experiments were undertaken to find out how varying levels of illumination, that is the amount of light at the workplace, affected the productivity or output. The hypothesis was that with higher illumination, the productivity will increase. The output showed an upward trend even when the illumination was gradually brought down to normal level. Now, the findings of this experiment were, the researchers found that as they increased the illumination in experimental group, both groups increased production. When the intensity of illumination decreased, the production continued to increase in both the groups. Therefore, it was concluded that there is no consistent relationship between output of the workers and illumination in the factory. There must be some other factor which affected productivity. The next experiments are relay assembly test room experiments. These experiments aimed at not only the impact of illumination on production, but also other factors such as the length of working day, rest hours, and other physical conditions. So in this experiment, a small homogeneous subgroup of 6 girls was constituted. These girls were friendly to each other and were asked to work in a very informal atmosphere under the supervision of a researcher. These workers were made feel important for the organization. They had recognition, attention from their supervisor. There was equal participation from the team. There existed a cohesive group environment and there was non-directive supervision. We could see that productivity and morale increased considerably during the period of the experiment. The findings of this experiment were: productivity went on increasing and stabilized at a high level even when all the improvements were taken away and the pre-test conditions were reintroduced. The researchers concluded that the socio-psychological factors such as the feeling of being important, recognition, attention, participation, cohesive work group, and non-directive supervision held the key for higher productivity. Mass interviewing program. During the course of experiments, about 20,000 interviews were conducted between 1928 and 1930 to determine employees' attitudes towards company, supervision, insurance plans, promotion, and wages. Initially, a direct approach was used whereby both the interviewer and the manager or supervisor was present, and questions were asked which were considered important by managers and researchers. The researcher observed that the replies of the workmen were guarded. Therefore, this approach was replaced by an indirect technique in which only the interviewer or the researcher was present and he simply listened to what the workmen had to say. Now, the findings of this study were: a complaint is not necessarily an objective of recital of facts. It is a symptom of personal disturbance, the cause of which may be deep-seated. Which means, when an employee is complaining about something, it doesn't mean that he's saying it just for the sake of saying it. He might have faced the issue personally, which might have disturbed him, and that is why he complains. The personal situation of the worker is a configuration composed of a personal preference involving sentiments, desires, and interest of the person and the social reference constituting to person's social past and his present interpersonal relations. The human relations movement sought to treat employees like human beings with personal feelings which affect the work. The position or status of worker in the company is the reference from which the worker assigns meaning and value to the events, objects, and features of his environment, such as hours of work, wages, etc. Which means to say that if there is a blue-collared employee, he will expect that he works for a certain amount of time and gets paid for the work he does. Whereas the top-level employee will have different references and different expectations for his kind of work. The social organization of the company represents a system of values from which the worker derives satisfaction or dissatisfaction according to the perception of his social status and the expected social rewards. The social demands of the worker are influenced by the social experience in groups both inside and outside the work plant. So basically, while interviewing the workers, the conclusion or the findings of the study were found that the social relationships which were involved in the work and as well as in the worker's personal life were very important factor which affected the work of the worker. The next experiment was the bank wiring observation room experiment. These experiments were conducted to find out the impact of small groups on the individuals. In this experiment, a group of 14 male workers were formed into a small work group, and there was an observer involved. The men were engaged in the assembly of terminal banks for the use in telephone exchanges. The work involved attaching wire with switches for certain equipment used in telephone exchanges. Hourly wage for each worker was fixed on the basis of average output of each worker. And bonus was also provided on the basis of group effort. Now, there are these management defined standards in every organization, but here it was observed that the group evolved its own production norms for each individual worker, which was made lower than those set by the management. Because of this, workers would produce only that much which was defined by the group, thereby defeating the incentive system. And those workers who tried to produce more than the group norms were isolated, harassed, or even punished by the group. The findings of this study were, each individual was restricting the output of the group. This happened because every individual's capacity to work is different and it hindered the final outcome of the group. The group had its own unofficial standards of performance. As we looked into it earlier, the management set standards were not followed by the group. Individual output remained fairly constant over a period of time, which means to say that there was no growth or improvement seen in the performance of the individuals. Informal groups play an important role in the working of an organization. Social behavior largely affects the work culture. Now let us look into the contributions of Hawthorne experiments. The first one is that management was now considered as a social unit. A factory is not only a techno-economic unit, but also a social unit, as men are social beings. This social characteristic at work plays an important role in motivating people. The output increased in, if you remember in the relay test room assembly experiment, the output increased due to effectively functioning of a social group with a warm relationship with its supervisors. Group influence. The workers in a group develop a common psychological bond, uniting them as a group in the form of informal organization. The behavior of the workers is influenced by these informal groups. Pressure of how a group rather than management demands frequently has strongest influence on how productive the workers can be. Group behavior. The management must understand that a typical group behavior can dominate or even supersede individual propensities. Motivation. Human and social motivation can play even a greater role than mere monetary incentives in moving or motivating and managing employee groups. Supervision. The style of supervision affects workers' attitude to work and his productivity. A supervisor who is friendly with his workers and takes interest in their social problems can get cooperation and better results from the subordinates. Working conditions. Productivity increases as a result of improved working conditions in the organization. Employee morale. Elton Mayo pointed out that workers were not simply cogs or machines. Instead, the employee morale, both individual and in the group, can have profound effects on productivity. Communication. Experiments have shown that the output increases when the workers are explained the logic behind the various decisions, and their participation in decision making brings better results. Balanced approach. The problems of workers could not be solved by taking one factor, that is, management could not achieve the results by emphasizing on one aspect. All the things should be discussed and decision should be taken for improving the whole situation. A balanced approach to the whole situation can show better results. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and share to Management Kaksha.